staples in his skull now and somehow lived to tell the tale. He sold NBC2 anchor Brennan Weick his survival story. And we want to warn you, some of the images we're about to show you are graphic.
You never understand the power of wild animal like that until you're in its mouth.
Jeffrey Heim shouldn't be alive.
99 times out of 100.
See if I could find a full tooth.
I would have gotten knocked out and drowned.
But no gators yet.
Instead, he has 35 staples and a minor skull fracture.
From what they had told me, I was the luckiest man alive.
After being attacked by a gator in the Myakka River.
A lot of good divers refuse to dive in that water. I just love it.
He makes a living spearfishing in the Keys, and in his spare time...
I love looking for these. Megalodon shark teeth.
He turns the fossils into jewelry, donating some of the proceeds to conservation efforts.
I'm turning my passion into something more constructive than just me enjoying it. Other people seem to enjoy it.
But Sunday, his passion turned into pain.
How long had you been in the water before this happened?
1 minute. Come up for a breath, and I felt like I got hit by a boat going 50 miles an hour. Felt like propeller to the head, and it pulled me down. It went bop, bop, real quick, head, hand. It was just so powerful, I thought it was a boat.
Oh. Jeffrey grimaced in pain during our interview just a day after the attack.
I look up, and the gator's just looking at me about 4 feet in front of me.
Somehow, he got out of the water before the gator could strike again.
So lucky that there's people right there. I yelled out immediately. I said, call 911. EMS was there in 5 minutes.
It wasn't until hours after he was rushed to the hospital.
Hey guys, just wanted to let you know I'm doing all right.
That the gravity of what happened set in.
He really wanted a megalodon tooth.
It was a lot to process. A lot of emotions, a lot of pain. It was in complete control. There's no knife or gun that could have saved me. Snuck up on me, I had no idea.
For now, he's taking mom's advice.
My mom's not going to let me dive the rivers anymore. I'm just going to go to the Gulf. Much safer.
And leaving you with his.
Don't dive during mating season. Don't dive in the Myakka River.
Even though the gator almost took his life, Jeffrey doesn't blame it. He thinks it may have been a female protecting her eggs since it is mating season. Florida wildlife officers tell me a trapper is working to remove the gator. Once that happens, it's up to the trapper to decide what to do with it, but they cannot release it back into the wild. Fatal gator attacks are not very common in Florida. The last time a person was killed by a gator in the state was actually in Lee County in 2019. Darden Battle was killed while trying to run from police by swimming across a retention pond in Fort Myers. The gator that got him was more than 10 feet long, so we can definitely confirm Jeffrey is a lucky man.
Oh my Lord, that story.
Seriously, I mean, the pictures, you see all the staples in his head. He said that's actually the perfect place because his skull is so strong.
So hard, right?
Right,
yeah.
Right. So yeah. It could have gotten his limb. Things could have been a lot worse. You would think the head would be bad.
Yes.
But it didn't get his face, and his skull protected his brain. So
certainly he is, as they say, lucky to be alive.
Definitely.
Thanks, Brenna.